since we got you, Tor, we got you in the building.
I'm here.
Let's talk a little bit about Double Barrel and how the whole project came about. How did you guys connect on this idea and decide, you know what, let's just do a whole project together?
It was real interesting how we hooked up. We actually met in the studio doing the skit for the EMC album. Ace called Marco and myself to play two characters on the album.
Ace, by Ace, we mean Master,
Master
Ace.
Master Ace, I'm sorry. Master Ace, the big homie. M.A., what up? Yeah, on the EMC album, the last album, the show, they have a skit called Backstage. And there's a nerdy guy looking for his girlfriend. She's backstage with the band, and there's a big brolic security guard guy. I guess you can kind of figure out who played who. Marco, of course, being the security guard. So we actually met in the studio, and I hollered at Marco, like, yo, I'm a big fan of what you're doing. And he kind of snubbed me. It was cool, though. He didn't know what I had in the clip. And a few weeks after that, it's that Toronto ego. Yeah. A few weeks after that, his record called Get It Done came out. You guys may have heard it. Produced by my man Primo. And then, Marco hit me in the MySpace. Like, yay! I love telling that story. Hey, guy, remember we met?
Yeah.
That's
cool. So you guys connected from there, started doing music. But was it a right away, like an instant connection, let's do an album together, or was it like, did it evolve into that?
Yeah, it was definitely more organic, and you know what I'm saying, like our whole friendship, you know what I'm saying, like it started in a real crazy space. And then it just evolved. He hollered at me like, yo, I'm doing this mixtape, the new Port Authority, to promote Port Authority that was out a couple years back, and asked me if I wanted to be a part of it. Of course, I said yes. And we actually did two records on there. I'm probably the only person who had two new records on the new Port Authority mixtape with Mick Boogie and Marco. And then from there, he invited me to come out with him and Moss and Attic for the EMC tour across Canada. I returned the favor when Ace took me to Europe. I brought Marco with me. And then we just kind of started, you know, building and working on ideas. But everything built real organically. Like, we never just said, yo, we're going to make an album because we both, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just made sense. It just started working together.
But you know what's dope about that is that you guys hung out, you know, in close quarters, you know what I mean? Just traveling, you know what I mean? And like, hanging out even before you started making music together.
Right.
So, like, you probably had inside jokes, things that you could talk about, hang out, and vibe about even in the studio, as opposed to, like, just approaching it from a work standpoint, because you guys had that.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Like, what Margo and I have is a friendship, and people always say, you guys going to do another album? And I'm like, we always going to continue to do music and everything, because, like, before all of that, that's the homie. You know what I'm saying? Like, I have a bond with Marco as a friend, and then the music is always going to be that much better because I'm not just going in with a producer. I'm going in and creating something with my dude. You know what I'm saying? And that makes the music more organic, and I think that's what's going to make it stand the test of time.
Well, maybe he'll be here to speak for himself. But in the meantime, thank you for joining us, Torre. More with Torre and, of course, Marco Polo throughout the show, man. Double Barrel is the name of the album. Real Freaks is the name of the show. This is the new Flow 93.5 live and direct on a Monday night, a freak night, never the week night. You are checking out the Real Frequency Show, and that can only mean one thing. Real hip hop is in the building. And look who decided to join the party, man.
Yo.
The one and only Marco Polo in the building.
Yes, sir.
Torre is in the building.
Yes, sir.
Double Barrel is the name of the album.
Completely CanCon.
I like that. Conveniently CanCon.
Yes.
CanCon enough.
Yes. Exactly.
Did you explain to Torre what CanCon is?
You see, I'm sitting here looking stupefied, right?
CanCon.
Nah, he knows what CanCon
is. Okay. You know what CanCon is? Canadian content.
Oh,
okay.
That means we can submit for the Junos with our album.
Yeah, let's do it. Shout out to Calgary.
Yo, me and Tor went to the Junos 2 years ago.
What?
Joke, yeah, because Port Authority got nominated.
Oh, man, that's crazy.
Took a little trip out there.
Hurry up.
Okay, so let's talk about things. Let's get caught up. I mean, the first break, we talked to Tor a little bit about how the whole project came together, how you guys kind of hooked up and put the damn thing together.
Yes, sir.
But the main thing that strikes me about this record, and the thing that I love about this record, is that it doesn't try to do anything other than be a completely raw rap record.
Yeah,
it doesn't really try to do any. It doesn't really try to rap to you even about, like, give you lessons of life. It doesn't try to be conscious. It doesn't really try to be pop. It doesn't try to appeal to anything other than the sensibilities of the real rap listener. And I think that's really missing in today's market. You know what I mean? Like a whole project dedicated to that. Like, it kind of makes you remember, like, oh yeah, this is why we love hip hop.
No doubt. Good looks.
You know what I'm saying?
This guy gets it. He gets it.
Yeah, man. You know, I mean, you know the deal. Hip hop rap over the years has taken a turn. You know, taken a turn for the many different directions.
Or took in.
You know. Let me use a rapper word right there.
Or took in.
But straight up, we made an album that we wanted to make. You know what I'm saying? We had to have fun with it, or else there's no point in doing it. You know what I'm saying? When I get in the studio, I'm trying to make something that I want to listen to as a fan of what I grew up on. The same with Tor. It was a real simple approach. You know what I'm saying? And like you said, it's just 14 shots to the head. You know what I'm saying? We're not trying to school you or teach you lessons. We're just trying to do hard rhymes, hard beats, and that's what we accomplished. So
I feel like rap has gotten so, hip hop has gotten so overthought over the years that just the back to basics kind of mentality is missing. You know what I'm saying? Because that spontaneity, that moment that you capture when you're recording in the studio, that very moment, that very time, that energy. It feels kind of like cats are going into studio or recording via Pro Tools and sending stuff, this, that, and the third. I mean, you know what I mean? There's nothing like just getting together with, you know, with the homie in the lab and recording and
Absolutely.
Putting something down right then and there.
Yeah, man.
That's what we did.
You can't overthink these things. You just got to rap over beats. You know what I'm saying? And Kevin, and that's that. You know
I love it, though.
Yo, but honestly, if you want content, you check Tory's Got It on Daily Conversation. If you want more diversity on the production side, check out Port Authority. But for this project, we had a vision, and we stuck to it. You know what I'm saying? And that's what we did. Real, 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 real.